वेलकम टू माय क्लास क्लास 12 फिजिक्स चैप्टर दैट इज अल्टरनेटिंग करंट एंड टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट फेजर एंड फेजर डायग्राम। फर्स्ट वी विल ड्रॉ द फेजर डायग्राम, देन वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द टर्म दैट इज फेजर, एंड फॉर दैट वी विल ड्रॉ टू सर्कुलर पाथ। दिस इज फर्स्ट सर्कुलर पाथ and this is another circular path. Two circular paths are there. And here also draw two axes. This one is the first axis. Suppose we write that is x, x prime. And another axis is there, second axis. We write that x is suppose y, y prime, and this point is the center or origin. We write that is O. Clear? And here we draw a vector starting from the origin O, and this vector O A vector, this O A vector is a rotating vector. Rotating vector means O A vector rotate in anti-clockwise direction with angular speed omega. Clear? Here O A is a rotating vector which rotates in anti-clockwise direction with angular speed omega about the origin O, so that this O A, this rotating vector O A is known as a phasor. Phasor means simply that is a rotating vector. We write the definition of a phasor. Phasor means that is phasor is a rotating vector Phasor is a rotating vector which rotates with angular speed, which rotates with angular speed omega in anti-clockwise direction. In anti-clockwise direction about the origin O. Clear? And here OA, that is one phasor. We draw another vector, second vector, starting from point O, and suppose this vector, this second vector, we write that is OB vector. Second vector, that is OB vector. That means two phasors are there. Both OA vector and OB vector are rotating in anti-clockwise direction with the same angular speed, so that both are known as phasor. That means OA is a first phasor. And their first phasor, suppose that is known as the current phasor, or that is also known as voltage phasor. We write that is voltage phasor. First phasor is known as the voltage phasor, that is OA vector. Second phasor, that is OB vector, we write that is the current phasor. Here two phasors are there, one is a voltage phasor and another is your current phasor. And suppose this angle, we write omega t, an angle between current phasor and voltage phasor, that is phi. And here phi is also known as the phase difference. Clear? That means phase of current phasor, that is phi plus omega t, phase of voltage phasor, that is omega t. and difference of phase, that is omega t plus phi minus omega t, that is phi. Phi is known as the phase difference. That means simply we write, to know the phase difference, that is phi, to know the phase difference between current phasor and voltage phasor, we use the term phasor. Simply we write here. Second point, that is to know or to calculate the phase difference that is phi between current phasor here current phasor in this figure current phasor that is OB vector so that in place of current phasor we write that is OB vector to know the phase difference between current phasor and voltage phasor that is also known as the EMF phasor and in figure voltage phasor that is the OA vector we write that is OA vector we use the term phasor clear phasor means simply the rotating vector that is known as the phasor that is a rotating vector but that is not vector that is a scalar quantity your current is a scalar quantity your voltage or potential difference or electromotive force means that is the EMF all are scalar quantity here simply represent as a rotating vector but that is a scalar quantity clear and look at the figure O to A, this is the magnitude of a voltage phasor. Similarly, O to B, this is the magnitude of the current phasor. And this magnitude of the phasor is the maximum value, or that is also known as amplitude, or that is also known as the peak value of the phasor. That means simply write number C. OA vector that is equal to look at the figure OA vector that is voltage phasor we write that is voltage phasor in AC circuit and what is OA we write magnitude of OA vector or this is equal to OA OA is equal to magnitude of voltage phasor and this magnitude of the voltage phasor this is known as peak value or that is also known as amplitude and in case of voltage phasor or EMF phasor we write that is E0 that is the maximum value or that is the peak value or that is the amplitude or that is the magnitude of the voltage phasor clear that means this is equal to O to A similarly we write another phasor is there second phasor that is OB vector OB vector is known as the current phasor so that we write OB vector that is equal to current phasor in an AC circuit then what is OB that is the magnitude of the OB vector or we write simply OB that is the magnitude of current phasor and here also magnitude of the current phasor that is also known as peak value, or that is also known as amplitude. And in case of a peak value of the current, we use the symbol that is I zero. I zero is the peak value of current, or that is the amplitude. E zero is the peak value of a voltage, or that is also known as amplitude. Clear? And here in figure, OA, that is a vector, OA vector, and we divide the OA vector into two rectangular components. One is horizontal component and another is vertical component. Simply we draw two components, or we divide the OA vector into two components. That means we draw a perpendicular to the horizontal axis, we draw another perpendicular to the vertical axis. Clear? Suppose this point, we write, suppose that is C point, and this point we write that is C1. If this angle is omega t, this angle is also omega t. Clear? And look at the figure. OC1A is a triangle. From OC1A, we can easily calculate the vertical component. Vertical component is O2C1. Horizontal component is O2C. O2C, this is the horizontal component, because this is situated along the horizontal axis. And O2C1, this is situated in the vertical axis, so that this is known as the vertical component. And to know the vertical component, here we calculate the sine theta. That means from triangle OC1A, we write here vertical component that is sine theta. Here in place of theta, omega t, this angle is omega t, or same thing, this angle is omega t, so that in place of theta we write omega t, sine omega t is equal to, from the triangle we get the sine omega t, that means front side of the omega t, that is OC1 divided by this one, is OA, we write OC1 divided by OA, we write OC1 divided by OA, that implies OC1 is equal to OA multiplied by sine omega t. We write that implies OC1 is equal to, what is OA? Look at the figure. Here OA, is the magnitude of the voltage phasor, and we write that is E0, so that here also OA, is the magnitude, and that is known as the maximum value, or we write that is E0. Here we write in place of OA, we write E0 sine omega t. Then what is OC1? O2C1, this is the instantaneous value of the voltage. For instantaneous value, we write that is E. E is the instantaneous value, that means magnitude of EMF at any instant of time t, or value of EMF or value of voltage at any instant of time t, that is known as the instantaneous value on the vertical axis. Clear? Because this is the vertical component, so that OC1, O2C1, we write that is E. E is the instantaneous value, so that in place of OC1, we write that is E. E is equal to E0 sine omega t. This is known as the vertical component. This is the vertical component of voltage, or we also write EMF, same thing. That is the vertical component of the EMF phasor. That is the vertical component of the EMF phasor. Similarly, what is the horizontal component? Another component is there, second component, that is known as the horizontal component. horizontal component of EMF phasor. And for horizontal component, look at the figure. Triangle is OAC. OC, OC is the horizontal component. O2C, this is the horizontal component. And to calculate OC, here first we will calculate the cos theta. Here theta means that is omega t. What is cos omega t? Cos omega t is equal to OC divided by OA. We write cos omega t is equal to OC divided by OA. That implies OC is equal to OA multiplied by cos omega t. That implies OC, O2C, this is the horizontal component, or that is the instantaneous value on the horizontal axis at any time t. OC, this is the instantaneous value at point C at any instant of time t. Similarly, OC1, this is the instantaneous value at any instant of time in the vertical axis. Clear? So that in place of OC, we also write E. In place of OA, we put that is the peak value. Peak value, we write E0. So that the expression becomes, your E is equal to E0 cos omega t. That means your two components are there. For horizontal component, we write E0 into cos omega t. For vertical component, we write that is E0 into sin omega t. These are the vertical component and horizontal component of current, sorry, of voltage phasor or EMF phasor. Clear? And look at the figure. OA, OA is known as the voltage phasor. OA vector, that is known as the voltage phasor. And here, we draw a perpendicular from point A to the point C1, so that we get OC1. OC1 is known as the instantaneous value, or that is also known as projection of voltage phasor on the vertical axis. That is also known as projection of voltage phasor on the vertical axis. Same thing. Clear? And in figure, in this figure, for voltage, we write that is E is equal to E0 into sin omega t for vertical axis. And for current, what is the phase? This one is the total phase, that is omega t plus phi. So that for current, we write I is equal to I0 into sin omega t plus phi. For current, here we write, for current, what is its instantaneous value? Its instantaneous value, we write I. I is equal to I0 into sin omega t plus phi. Clear? And phi, this phi is known as the phase difference. This phi is known as the phase difference. And from this figure, finally we get, for current, this is the equation. And for voltage or EMF, we get the equation that is E is equal to E0 sin omega t. If we compare these two equations, we get here phase is omega t plus phi. Here phase is omega t plus phi. That means phase of current is lead by an angle phi. So that if we compare EMF and current, we write finally current leads because of plus phi. Plus phi means we write lead, minus phi means we write lags behind. Clear? So that we write current leads by an angle, or you also write by phase high as compared to EMF. Clear? Your current leads by phase phi as compared to EMF. If you compare these two equations, we write this one. Then what is the phasor diagram? What is phasor diagram? This one is the phasor diagram. This is the phasor diagram. Phasor diagram means any diagram that represent two phasor. One is alternating current phasor. And another is alternating voltage phasor. And both the phasor having same frequency. Clear? That means the diagram in which alternating current phasor is there and alternating voltage phasor is there, and both the phasor having the same frequency, the diagram is known as the phasor diagram. Clear? Now we draw another phasor diagram. Suppose alternating EMF is given, that is E is equal to E0 sin omega t, and current, alternating current is also given, that is the instantaneous alternating current. We write that is I0 sin omega t minus pi by 2, just like this. Here phase is omega t minus pi by 2 means lags behind. So that if we compare these two equations, we write current lags behind by phase angle, this one, pi by 2 radian as compared to this one, that is EMF. Clear? Minus pi by 2, we write lags behind. Plus pi by 2, we write leads or ahead. Clear? And here we draw the phasor diagram of current and EMF only in this case. Same thing, we take this one is the first circle, we take another circle, second circle, this one is the second circle, and we also draw two axes. This one is the first axis, suppose that is the x axis. Another axis is there, we write suppose that is the y axis. And this point is the origin, we write that is origin O. First phasor that is the voltage phasor or EMF phasor, that is E is equal to E0 sin omega t. We draw the first phasor. This one is the first phasor. And this angle, we write that is omega t, and this is known as the EMF phasor. Clear? And another phasor is there, second phasor, that is the current phasor. Here equation is I0 sin omega t minus pi by 2 means your minus sign is there, so that lags behind. Lags behind means in this direction. This is the lags behind. this is leads. Leads means because phasor here rotated in the anti-clockwise direction. So that leads means in the anti-clockwise direction. Lags behind means in the clockwise direction. Here pi by 2 means we draw another phasor for current. This is the second phasor, that is current. And this total angle between the EMF phasor and current phasor, that is the phase difference phi, and in this case this is pi by 2, and this phasor, this is known as the current phasor. This is known as the current phasor. Clear? If the equations are just like this, if the equations, one equation, that is the E is equal to E0 sin omega t, that is for the alternating EMF. Another equation, that is the current, that is the instantaneous current, that is I0 into sin omega t minus pi by 2. Here I means that is the instantaneous current at any instant of time t. I0 is the peak value, or that is the amplitude, or that is the maximum value. Here omega is the angular speed, and omega t minus pi by 2, this total, that is the phase, and pi by 2, that is the phase difference. Pi by 2, that is the phase difference, and here pi by 2 is the phase difference between EMF and current. In figure, this is the pi by 2. This pi by 2 is the phase difference between EMF and current, and this is a diagram. And in this diagram, two phasors are there. One phasor, that is the current phasor. Second phasor, that is the EMF phasor, and this is the phase difference between the two phasors. So that this diagram is known as the phasor diagram. This diagram is known as the phasor diagram for this type of equation. Clear? And this is all about your phasor and phasor diagram. And in the next class, we will discuss about AC circuit containing resistor only. And thank you.